So after I finished yesterday's episode, I realized that we actually did not qualify for the round of 16 of the Champions League. And it's in the most bullshit way possible. We are not in here. And just look at the reason why. We are drawn on points because of that loss to Copenhagen. And the annoying thing is that we have a higher goal difference. We are on 2, they are minus 2. And for some reason, we are third on the table. And this actually pissed me off yesterday, but I got to vent out already, so I'm not really that pissed about it anymore. But I'm not going to focus on the Europa League. I'm just going to sim past it because I really do not fucking care about that competition anymore, because I'm supposed to be in Champions League and for some reason I'm in the Europa League, and it's just not my business if I win it or not. The first order of business in this match is first versus second. Barcelona is first, we are second, and we absolutely have to win this match by all means necessary, because they are the ones that we are fighting with for that top spot in this season. And it just means I'm going to have to go all out. I'm going to have to use my best squad, the best squad I can throw out there, and that's this one that's currently on the screen right now. And let's hope that we can defeat them. Hopefully we do, so that we can get up to top, up to first, and we don't have to, I mean, we should be able to defeat the other teams that come after them. So we are at the Camp de Cohetes, our prestigious stadium, and we are going up against Barcelona. The last time we faced them, it was a stalemate, goalless draw, and let's see if we can make a difference in this match. I mean, we had a bunch of opportunities that we missed, a bunch of really, really good opportunities that we weren't able to. Alright, so that's good from Vandre to start. It was actually a very bad defensive mistake there, but thankfully he saved us. They have another counter-attack. I really hope that this is not what this match is just going to be. Them having counter-attacks upon counter-attacks, that's just going to be bloody annoying. Thank you, Helvig, as usual. So that this is legit what they're trying to do. And I'm pretty sure that when it's our turn for an attack, they're going to give me a bloody free kick or something like that. We got this. What the hell? Alright, that's good. Okay. And of course, we don't get a fucking counter attack. Get a bloody crossing scenario. But let's see what we can make from this. Ugh. All right, we have a second try. See German, and I wanted him to use his fucking leg. Apparently, that just doesn't work sometimes. See Haaland, looking like the best opportunity here. Fonseca open, and that is the first goal of this match. Finally, we are scoring against Barcelona. Jesus, it's been so long. It's been so fucking long. I think the last time we scored against them was the last time I played a full match against them. Alright, so I guess it's our turn for the counter-attacks upon counter-attacks. So, Florian Wirtz, you see, German is the best option here. And can you go around De Jong? Yes, you can. And that was insane. That was insane. The keeper did not see that coming at all. I did not see that coming at all. I'm sure no one fucking saw that coming. That was a really good goal from German. We have possibly the last attack for this match. And I'm feeling like doing something crazy here. I don't know how this will work out. But Oh my days, that actually works. When did we get a fucking red card? That is bullshit. But that is insane that we actually score that. So 3-0 against Barcelona, the team that we always find it so hard to beat. We are making the most of all our attacking options and fucking them up big time. Alright, so that's the end of the match. 3-0, And those German goals, man, those German goals were insane. I cannot believe the second one in particular was out of this fucking world. Where is that? Okay, this is the first one. I actually want to see the close-up view of this goal, because that was insane. He went round De Jong or whoever that is. That doesn't even look like De Jong anymore, but he played it with his left leg first before he tricked keeper with his right leg, and that is insane. And then this one, I didn't know it was going to work out. I just took a shot at goal, and it paid off really, really well. That was another really good goal. So with that, we are now first on the table with 2 points ahead of Barcelona, and they can easily take it back if we keep on playing like fucking fools in the simulations. But we have Atletico Madrid next, and there's no way I'm going to leave this match up to chance. No fucking way. I'm going to have to do it myself. That kit is okay, and I'm going to bring Camavinga in for who exactly? I think I'll be okay bringing him in for Pedri. So if he is kind of injured, I'm just going to bring Lunin on for this match. Bino Gittins, I'm not sure about you for this match though. So I'm just going to keep it like this, and let's see how well we're going to do in this match. All right, so we're at the Wanda Metropolitano, and I don't know, this stadium has so many names in this game. This one is Civitas Metropolitano. I don't know if they changed the name in real life or some other shit just happened. I really don't know, and I really don't care, but like, all right, let's see what. Why do they always have the first attack though? Okay, I guess nothing I can really do about it. Please don't try and fuck up the defense like you did last match. Thank you. Okay, so we have an interesting chance here. I don't know if this is going to get to Haaland or... Okay, Haaland. Alright, straight to the keepers. Straight down to the keeper. Please. Alright, Vandre, thank you. Thank you so much for that. We have a solo run here. I do not know... Okay. No, that's offside. Is it? No, it's not. Alright, that's good. So that's 1-0. Fonseca. German, Haaland, and Fonseca are the ones that made that possible. And I think this might be a good chance for German or Haaland, one of them. Most likely German. His best option. Unless I want to sweat it off to Haaland, which I would not do. And thank God Fonseca was right there to get his second goal of the match. And then we have yet another attack. It's looking like we're about to demolish Atletico Madrid once again. It's looking quite possible. Alright, I do not know why he used his left leg, but that was insane finishing right there. So that is 3-0. And we have a counter attack. Fonseca looking like the best option. Not anymore. Don't know why he had to wait, but let's see what German got. Alright, so that is the fourth goal for this match. I don't know if he has scored already. No, he hasn't. This should be the first one he scored. Now we have yet another attack. We're actually buried every single one of this scenarios. And that is good. That's what I want to see. Just wasn't enough, and this is probably the last attack of the match. So 4-0 it is. I'm settling with that. I'm good with that. Have no problems with that. And all right, good. I have no idea why Karim Adeyemi was playing in defense there. I have no bloody idea why the fuck he was playing defense, but whatever. This was a really good match. Really, really good match. Very, very surprising that we're able to get the win like this. Next up, we have Barcelona again for the semi-finals of the Copa del Rey, Copa de España, whatever it's called. And I think I would let let's do something like this real quick. Okay, so Helvey goes there, Guardiola goes here, and Tomiyasu will play here. Yeah, he's not very happy, he's not getting a lot of playing time. That's not very good, but I think I should be okay with this formation. So I would want to simulate it, but that is just not something I want to do against Barcelona, because we haven't beaten them in any of these simulations that we played, and for some reason we did really well in the last match. So I'm really hoping that we can actually take that performance and put it into this match, repeat it, even though it's in our stadium once again. And it will be nice if we are able to beat them, defeat them back to back, and we possibly might still face them in the Copa del Rey, and that will make it four times I'm facing them. They have a counter attack already. They started with three counter attacks in the last match that we played against them. We're able to weather every single one of them. It's not looking like that's the case for this one though, and we might just be the luckiest fucking team in the world right now to be able to have escaped that. All right, everyone is Cirise looking like the best option, and I probably should have sweated off to German. But they have a counter attack here, and we're able to weather that storm. I see the three of them are right there, ready for this through ball, and goes to Haaland. I mean, obviously, this is going to be a sweat. Obviously, this is going to be a sweat. Yeah, it's that easy. That fucking easy, man. So Fonseca is getting get another goal against Barcelona. That's three goals against Barcelona in just this episode alone, and we have yet another bloody fucking counter attack. I see Haaland. I don't think a through pass will be. I hate this game so much. I hate this game so bloody much. We almost considered a fucking penalty there. Thank God the ref didn't see that. That is a load of crap. Oh my God, Vandre. This guy is a fucking savior. Alright, we're in the final of the Super Copa. Not really interested. I'm definitely going to have to play though, because I want to win it this time around. Even though it's not really that important to me, but I still want to win it though. So just 3 days later is the finals of this competition, and I want to go all out here. So I'm going to use all the best players of the team. I'm going to use my strongest team for Real Madrid, even though Real Madrid is not really a threat to me anymore. But now that I've said that, it's probably jinxed, so I'm going to have to work extra hard to make sure to take advantage of all of the opportunities that I'm giving, the same way I've been doing ever since. I mean, last month we didn't really get that many opportunities though, and the ones that we got, the computer did fuck it up for us. But I mean, still good that we're able to win that 1-0. We are not in our home stadium. I honestly thought that they do this in their home stadium, but I guess that was just because it was Real Madrid that was the home side that other time. But that's not really important. What's important is us winning this match, and we should be able to win against Real Madrid here. We should be able to. So Fonseca looks like the best person to pass to right now, if the game doesn't fuck you up like that. I hate it so much. I hate it so fucking much. It's so irritating when that happens. It's so fucking irritating when that happens. Like what the actual fuck? Ah, alright, so we have a corner, and Courtois is the person we're going up against. I do not know what the fuck I want to do here. This guy is huge. Let's just risk the Panenka, and yeah. I didn't know. I mean, if I wanted to blast it to any other angle, there's a possibility that he would still catch it because he's just that big. I mean, if he dives the wrong way, he's possibly going to catch it. So the best thing to do was that, I guess. And now let's hope that we can get this straight to German. I mean, he stopped running already. And yeah, the game legit just does everything to fuck you up. Legit. I mean, I'm very sure that with the speed he could have caught that. For some reason, he did not. And that was smooth as fuck. Okay, still with the ball. Who's there? Camavinga doesn't get to you. No, it doesn't. All right, so we've lost the ball there. And tell me it's our... Okay, no, they have a good opportunity. And I just have to make sure that I don't fuck this lead up. Yeah, they're definitely pressing us right now and getting more attacking options. Let's try and not lose focus here. Vinicius is the main threat, so I have to make sure he's covered. That was very good from Stewart. That was very good from Stewart to help us get this trophy one last time. I mean, if that ball went through, that player would have been in on goal. And I do not know. I mean, it's really 50-50 if Andre is going to save that or not. So that is one more trophy in our trophy cabinet. And I really don't know how many we've gotten. I calculated 11 last time, so maybe this is 12. I will still calculate them at the end of the episode of the series. Maybe like at the beginning of the last episode, I probably will calculate them and let you guys know how many trophies we've won so far. But lifting that is really not my business. So we have La Liga action, we have Copa del Rey action, we have Europa League action, which I'm not interested in. Maybe I'm just going to do like normal simulations for those matches. So I'm going to simulate to that second one, the second leg there, and look for the best in the first leg, and then simulate the second leg and see what we can do there. So we win against Deportivo Alaves, we draw against Athletic Bilbao, that's not very good, and then we win against Eibar in the first round of the Copa del Rey, and then we win against Levante, and then the last one is going to be against Osasuna. I really hope that we get the win here. Yes, we do. We have Celta Vigo coming up next, but we defeat Sevilla before we get to that match, and we draw it. So I think that should be the first leg, so the second leg will be coming up. So we win against Zaragoza, and then against Celtic we win 4-0. So I'm really not obliged to play the second leg, to be honest, because there's no way we're going to be losing that 4-0 or 5-0 or something like that. So what the hell did I do? Yeah, there's a bunch of messages here. Let's see what they are. Okay, it's all tournament prize monies and stuff that are really that important. Let's look at the objectives real quick. I think I have fucked up for it to be moving down right now. Well, we can't win the Champions League, so they've given us the objective to win the Europa League instead. With two seasons, increase the team's experience level. We're probably not going to get that. It's on 27.2. It's just like 0.8 left to get to 28. So I think if I want to do that, I might have to release like one of the younger players in the team to maybe get to that stage. But we're in the semi-finals of the Copa de España. We're going to have to play that. The highlights, though. Reduce player wages to 260,000 a week. Can't do that. No way I'm going to fucking do that. I don't even think I can do that. Alright, so we're going to be simulating to the second leg of the Copa del Rey semi-finals. We win against these guys 4-1. Let's see what we did against. Yeah, we beat them 4-2, so that is 8-2 in on aggregate. That is a huge victory. We're going up against Sampdoria next, but let's just focus on the second leg of this competition right now, of the Copa del Rey. All right, nothing important there. I saw a message from a player. Let's see what that is about. Thanks for listening to what I had to say. Blah blah blah. Great performance. I mean, I'm even playing him in this coming match right now. Probably not for James, for one of the other players there. Haaland is kind of low on stamina. Don't know why. So he's going to. Camavinga is happy. He's making Mount that is not happy right now. I think I'm going to give Lunin a chance here, even though he is happy. That's because he's not really. Fulham is not happy. What the hell? How the hell is he not happy? Is there any other player that is playing above him in this team? I'm really confused with that. That really confused me. I'm going to have to check that out later on to see if he's actually getting playing time or not. That's weird. And then I just didn't play him this time. I played Risse over him. I think Risse is the one that should be getting more playing time, or Bino Gittins, because he can play right mid, and that is a right mid position, not a right winger, which Foden is. So that might just be the problem. So we are in our stadium for the second leg of the semi-finals of the Copa de España, and we have a crossing opportunity first. We should have way more opportunities against Celta Vigo. I don't really think that they're a team that would give us that many headaches. And yeah, that was poor judgment there. But we still have the ball. No, we don't. Can't believe that guy fucking lost out. Alright, so Fonseca, you're looking to be in a very good position. So yeah, just that was a very good catch. And no way you're going to miss that. Make sure I did not fuck that up. And that's 4-3 on aggregate, 1-0 in this match. Fonseca at it again. So they have a solo run, but Vardio is going to be the player that will save our asses right now. Let's try and not fuck this up, guys. Oh my god, that was scary. That was fucking scary. Alright, so Balunin did do well there. They have an attack in. Okay, I mean, you probably could have caught that. Don't know why the hell you did not. But now we have a solo run. Fonseca doesn't really have any helpers. Alright, there is this guy there, though. Karim Adeyemi might go for goal himself. And man freaking missed that. How the hell did that happen? How the hell did you not get that? I mean, not scoring gets me really agitated. Alright, good. Please tell me we are next. Yes, we are. We have... Alright, it's not a very clear attack, but we could probably do something. Probably already wasted it, but let's see what we got here. We still have the ball. No, we don't. Alright, so one... Okay, we probably have a couple more attacks. Probably one more after this. I don't know, but let's see if this corner is going to work out. That's Helvey coming in for us. Back to Pedri. James, what do you got? I mean, you did get ahead on this, but it just wasn't enough. Then we have a free kick here for German. I think I might want to take this. It's just that his curve isn't really all that, but his power is crazy though. So I guess I'm going to go for power over anything else here. And let's hope that this does work out. What the hell was that? What the actual fuck was that? Well, that was bullshit, if you ask me. Now that was fucking stupid. I mean, I didn't even get to see if it hit the wall or anything, just went off. But whatever. Fonseca did really well to get the first goal for us. Don't know why Adeyemi did not get that. But anyway, I wanted to check if Foden is actually getting play time. If not, I might have to get him up to right winger. That position, I might have to take up to right winger. So appearances, Foden should be. Yeah, he's not actually. He actually isn't. That is fucking sad. He's not getting. So who is the person that's getting more playing time? It should be Bino Gittins, if I'm not wrong. It should be him that is getting. Yeah, he's the one that's getting more playing time on that wing. So, that just means he should have more goals. He's definitely going to have more goals because of that. Yeah, he's getting more than Risse and Foden. But I don't think he has more goals. Yeah, Foden hasn't really scored that many goals this time around. Fonseca is on 35, as you guys saw there. He's absolutely fucking flying once again. So I'm going to have to switch this to a right winger so that he's not really left out. I don't think I have to do any instructions on that. So we're through to the finals of the Copa del Rey yet again, and I'm going to simulate to the second leg of that Europa League match in case I have to do anything. We're actually doing really well in the league this time around. That's a 3-0 win, so I'm not really going to be obliged to play in second one as well. I only seem to those dates if I feel like it's necessary for me to play the match, and that is another 3-2 win. So we are through to the next round. I don't know if it's the quarterfinals or the semifinals. It should be the quarterfinals since we are still in March. So 3-1 to Real Betis. Then we have Barcelona next, so that is going to be fucking 6 times that we're playing them in this season. All right, that is crazy. That is fucking crazy. Which just makes me not want to play this one. I don't think I have to play it. Although it's the league, so it's more important. So I think I should play this one. I've been playing pretty well. Blah blah blah. Yeah, I will give you playing time. But let's see if Foden's amount of appearances has come up with that. It was on 14 before, now it's on 18, and by negation is still on 32. So I guess that worked out. So the Barcelona match, I'm going to simulate this. Oh no, I'm going to do the highlights. I'm going to simulate the ones of the Europa League if I have to, and if I have to, I'll play the second leg. So I'm going to be going all out here. All right, so we're at the Nou Camp, or the El Libertador as the game calls it, and we have a tough match coming up against Barcelona. We've beaten them twice already this season. They've beaten us once. I think they beat us in the... No, I'll check it when we're doing the season. I don't think I have to stress myself here. All right, so Fonseca, this for you. Yes, it is. And that is a really good goal to start. Really good finishing from Fonseca. And that is yet another goal that he's scoring. This guy remains a beast. To me, he remains the best player in the world. And... okay, so I don't know why there's so many players here. That's really odd. Well, let's see if this thing will still work. It does not. We still have the ball though. But what can German do here? Get it to Haaland. That is actually really good. And then crap, it doesn't work out. It doesn't work out. That would have been a really, really good goal if it actually came off. But now we have to weather the storm and try and guess which way this guy is going to go. Fuck. All right, so they equalize with a penalty. Rodrigo did really well for them, and they have a corner kick here. I don't know if they're still second or not. They probably shouldn't be, but we've been winning a lot of matches, so I guess we should be in a good position. What the hell just happened there? What the fuck just happened there? Alright, so we have an attack here. The mini thing there is really confusing me. And that was probably not the best pass. Probably not the best course of action there. But we have another corner kick here. And this one looks like it might work. So Haaland, come and get this. Real quick. Back to Pedri. That was actually a little bit wide, and yeah, Guardiola is not going to do anything about that. And alright, that probably wasn't going to work out ever. Alright, okay, so we probably have one more attack after this if the game doesn't fuck me up. So we should be able to weather this storm. Hopefully we can. I feel like, yeah, I just knew that was going to happen. I just knew that was going to happen, but I was too late to try and stop it. Okay, this is not very good. Okay, so that is... Alright, so we have one more attack, like I said. And it's looking like Haaland might be the best option if the game doesn't already close him down. Oh my god, how did he miss that? How did he fucking miss that? Fonseca, come on. I swear to God, if he wasn't the best player in the world, man, I would have gotten him the fuck out of my team a long ass time ago. Because I mean, he misses a lot of one-on-one chances. Maybe not as many as he scores, but I mean, it's still supposed to be something that you should. I mean, the ratio at which he scores should be a lot higher than what it is right now. All right, thanks for giving me a chance. Sorry about what I've got to say. Hey, been subbed off, blah blah blah. We'll make sure every next time. Let's just do everything to make players happy right now. Okay, that is my priority. Okay, so next up we have Barcelona. I'm going to simulate this one like the normal simulation. I'm not going to do it with the calendar, so I don't trust that thing for shit. Sorry. So I'm not going to go all out for the first leg here. I'm not going to. No, I think I should though. I think I should. That's what I'm going to do. So quick sim. Are we going to be able to win it? Yes, Fonseca does get the win, but the second leg might be trickier. That's not a very, very fulfilling win, to be honest. So the second leg, I need to make sure that we do win that. So we don't get the win against that team. I don't know what they're called, but now we have the Barcelona match. This is going to be a really tough one. I really hope that we can actually pull through and win this match. But I'm going to have to play either ways because say it's going to be fairly important. I also want to go all out here, but I won't really go all out like that. Foden stuff is actually increasing. That's what I love to see. Then Camavinga, Mount. I think Mount should get a chance to play here. And I think I'm good with that. So playable highlights for this match. We're winning them 1-0 on aggregate, so we have the upper hand even if they score first. But we just got to make sure that they did not win this match no matter what. We have to defend very well, attack very well. I think we've beaten them more times than they've beaten us. I think it was only that first match in the first episode of this season that they beat us. So other than that, we've been absolutely balling them left and right. I think we also drew one. But we've already won two of them now, and well, they have a free kick in the 5th minute, and our players are probably going to handle this because our players are really good in the air. They're really, really good in the air. Yep. Even the short folks like Stewart. All right. So yeah, we have another free kick to weather, and probably are going to be able to handle this as well. So come on, guys. Vandre does come to collect, and that is good. So we have a counter attack of our own here. Rise looks like he's the best. No, he's not. I think I would rather give this to. Okay, that was weird as fuck. Why the hell are you going to use your head to do that? But we have a free kick in a very, very interesting position, I tell you. And I think Fonseca, which is just the man for this job. Let's look at his stats real quick. Alright, so 95 free kick accuracy, 99 power, curve 90. Okay, so the curve is the only thing that I have an issue with right here. But I think that we should be able to get. We should be able to get this in from this angle. I really hope that's the case. But I don't think I put enough power on that. Yeah, I didn't put enough power on that. All right, so they have a penalty. And Pedro Gonzalez, if I'm not wrong, is the one that is going to be on this. What the fuck? Are they always? The last two penalties I've failed to save, they all took it to that angle. And now this is fucked up. This is so fucked up. Okay, come on. Thank you. Alright, so this would be our goal. Has to be, man. German, come on. Thank you. All right, so that is 2-1 on aggregate, 1-1 in the match, and that was a really good goal. And now we have another attack, so this might be interesting. Don't know what I want to do yet, but Haaland looks like the best option, and man, all right, we do win it either ways. So that's 2-1. We draw this one. So we are going to the semi-finals of this competition. So if we face Barcelona in the semi-finals, I'm really curious to see who we're going to face. Sorry, in the quarterfinals, I'm really curious to see who we're going to face in the finals. That's a 3-0 win against Espanyol, and then we have Girona next before we go up against Villarreal in the Copa del Rey finals. Okay, so I think I might want to play the Europa League final, so I wouldn't play this one. I'll just do playable highlights for this one. Let's look at the thing real quick. I mean, it's really tempting to play against them. We have Manchester City next, so I don't really want to expend a lot of energy on Villarreal of all people, even though it's the Copa de España finals. I think this is really the second time we're facing them here, but Haaland is not going to start. Anyway, let him just start. Then by negating, I think I will give you a chance to play in that position in this match, and then Camavinga over. Yeah, he's actually low on stamina, so I'm going to play Mount for Pedri instead, and let's see what we're going to be able to do in this match. This is a final match. It's going to be very, very important and very, very crucial that we do win it. I really hope that we do win it though. I also have no idea where we are in the La Liga, but we're most definitely first, because we haven't lost a match since that match where we overtook Barcelona, and that is good. I mean, we drawn only one from then, and I doubt Barcelona has done that well, to be honest, to be able to catch up, to be able to stay on our tail. So let's forget about that. So right now we have a big match against our bitter rivals in the Copa de España finals. This is going to be the third time I'm going to be appearing in these finals, and man, we might be able to get a treble this season as well. But in the form of the Europa League, it's not really impressive. But I mean, it's a treble. So Fonseca, what do you got for me? And that was very fucking stupid. That was very fucking stupid, to be honest. That was incredibly stupid, man. Okay, not who I wanted. What the fuck? That's not how I wanted that whole thing to turn out. The game definitely fucked me up there. But Haaland is looking like he's in a good position, and I hope this works out. Does it? German looks like he's the better option, and yeah, that is the first goal in the 55th minute of this match, and German coming on for Bandwagon is getting his first goal, possibly his first touch. I do not know if it's his first touch or not. But Villarreal have a solo run here. This is going to be very, very fucking dangerous. Let's just hope that we can catch him. And yes, he fell for it. Okay, that's very good. Let's see what James got. And that... Oh, that was close. That was actually close. And Rice is on a free kick right now. It's odd. I didn't really think that he was the free kick type. Yeah, his stats are not really all that. I think I would much prefer German take this. I mean, they're all left-footed, and German's power is relatively good. So I think I would want him to have it. What the fuck? I think I would want him to have a go at this, though. So let's see what he can do. Let's try and drop it down a little bit, and hopefully that's not too much. Man, it was not too much. I probably need to add more power there, but I mean, it's very tricky shooting with him. It's not really that smooth. It's not really that good, to be honest. I don't know why. But whatever, we do win the Copa del Rey for the third time in a row, and we are beating Villarreal to win it for the second time in a row. That is good. So I think if I skip it, they're going to skip the trophy scene, so I'm not going to do that.
And now for the trophy lift itself. The cup winners.
Alright, so there we have it. No chairs as well, for some reason. But we have won the Copa del Rey yet again. the trophy that had eluded us for the longest of times. We have won it 3 times in a row. That is crazy. So next up, we have Manchester City. We have the Real Madrid match before that. I'm going to have to play that Real Madrid match. I'm going to do it. So we beat what's their face? What's their face? I don't know what their face is. Manchester City, yes, 2-1. And we have a match against Real Madrid here. We have done relatively well against these guys. Really, really well against them, to be honest. Let's go with this. This is most sensible. Alright, so can't go all out here because we have really important match coming on. This guy. Whoa, he's actually an academy player, and he's 88. Okay, Mount has definitely just lost his place in my team. I did not notice this guy was here, and he's how old? 22. That is really, really interesting. So I guess he's definitely going to have to start playing a couple games now. That's the only change I want to make. Let's see how well he can even do. So we're at the Santiago Bernabeu for the 3rd time this season, I think, if I'm not wrong. I really can't remember, to be honest. I don't even know why I said that. But okay, we're starting with a counter-attack. And yeah, it's probably best to hold the phone. Give to Fonseca. Let's see what he got from here. And man, that was insane. That was an insane goal from him. The attack, the everything, the passing was, everything was just so fucking sweet. So we have one more. What am I saying? One more. We have yet another counter attack. And I think. Okay, you're not the best option. Oh my god. Okay. Better. Probably on your hat-trick in this match. 2 goals against Real Madrid in the 6th minute of the game. And we are absolutely fucking flying. Real Madrid have a crossing opportunity, so we just have to block all of their passing options here. Alright, thank you, Guardiola, for that. We have yet another opportunity here. It's not a counter though, but looks like something that Haaland can take advantage of. Let's see what you can do with the power shots. Fontaine, wherever he's called, gets a hand on that. And all right, so we should be able to work, deal with this. All right, so they have a crucial opportunity for themselves in the 54th minute. We're already in the second half. 2-0. I mean, it's good that we got those 2 goals early on. Okay, that was good positional play from Stewart's, and just like that, we are done. I'm not going to complain. Apparently, we have won the league, so I guess I doubt we're going to lift it here at the Bernabeu. That's just going to be stupid. There's a couple of other matches that we haven't played, so I mean, we should lift it in our next home game, if I'm not wrong. But I just want to, I'm not going to wait and see. For if we're going to lift the trophy right after the Villarreal win. Alright, so we're actually not lifting the trophy. That is good. So I guess I'm going to have to play our next home game just so that we can see ourselves lift that La Liga trophy. I don't think I've ever seen us lift it before. I'm always simming through those whenever we win it. So this is an opportunity to see us lift the trophy for the first time. We have a tough match against Manchester City next. And to be honest, I'm not really feeling like playing this. I'm going to go all out though. And let's see if we are going to be able to defeat them at the Etihad, please. Yes, we do. Haaland gets a fucking hat-trick against his previous team. That is crazy. That is fucking crazy. He actually does get a hat-trick against them. So that is 5-2 on aggregate. And we are through to the finals. We're going to be going up against AS Monaco. That's not going to be a tough one. Hopefully it's not a repeat of last year's Champions League final. I really can't believe that us, that are Champions League winners, are going to be playing in the finals of the Europa League in the next season. That's just not fair. The game did us dirty. The next match is going to be this one against what's their face? Vallecano. We draw that one against that team. I don't know why the hell we're going to be loose guarding matches now, even though we pretty much already won it. We have three matches to go, and we are 10 points clear from Atletico Madrid in second position. And all right, so this is the match that I want to play. I'm talking about a full match. Yes, I want Sorgos to be fair to them, because we're most likely going to demolish them like crazy. But I will play this one. Just bring in Rice. Haaland is probably going to have to come off in the second half because he's low on stamina. And then this guy, Willems. Oops. Okay, can you stop doing shit like that? For Pedri, and then Camavinga for Florian Wirtz. I think I'm good. I think I am good with this. So Vandre is going to be on keeper duties today as usual. And I mean, I'm not going to underestimate them. Even though we lose the match, we're still going to lift the trophy at the end. But I guess it might be fun if we score at least like 4 goals or something like that. Hopefully it's more than that. You know, I don't know. So Fonseca is on 31 goals already. He probably is going to score a couple in this match. Hopefully he does. But let's just try and make that a possibility. Remember, do not underestimate opponents, even though our team is obviously way, way better than them on paper. Let's just try and do our defensive duties well. That is good from Stewart. And then after defensive duties, you do your possession keeping well. And you do your passing well and shite. He got too excited there. Definitely got too excited there. The La Liga goal record, I think that's 50 goals or 51 goals. That's messy. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. But that was good play from, I see. Oh my god. We're doing really well. We're doing really well in attack. And that would have been one hell of a chipping goal. Of a chipped goal. That would have been one hell of a chipped goal, to be honest, if that actually came through. So let's try and keep the ball here as well. That's really good from Willems. And are we going to be able to get this? I don't know. Yeah, it's already long gone. Let's see. Can Rice get to this? He can. And yes, that's the first goal from Takefusa Rice. Takefusa. I think that's his full name here. All right. So good start to the match. We have pressed them really well. We have been really good in possession. And we finally buttressed that with a really good goal. I think a victory for me here will be a clean sheet. That's how much more we are better than them. That's how much more we're better than them. So I think that is what I want to do, and I have completely lost the plan I had in mind there. But what does Camavinga have? Alright, so the shot wasn't really the most powerful, but it was something. Okay, what do we have? That wasn't really... Okay. Okay, that was a very interesting goal. German didn't like make that cross very well, but Camavinga, for some reason, was able to head that into the back of the net. Helvig is injured. That is not a very good sign. I think I'm going to have to take him off here just for safety reasons. Going to bring Kofi on for safety reasons, to be honest. I don't want him to miss out on that finals, and I really hope that the injury is not too bad that he will have to miss out on the finals either ways. All right, so we're able to keep the clean sheet there. That was actually really, really fucking scary. And please tell me that's not offside. Ah, crap. Ah, crap, that pass really wasn't all that. Really wasn't what I needed. But what. Alright, so that's. That chance is long gone already. Kamavinga looks like he's in a really good. Yeah, I probably should have passed back to Fonseca. I don't know how he would have done it, but I probably should have just tried to do that. But okay, so. First half done and dusted. We are moving to the second half now. Haaland is not doing well. So I guess I'm just going to have to take him off just to save him for the match against Monaco. Okay, that is. What the hell? What the hell was that? Okay, that was risky, but. Okay, yeah, that is. What the hell? What the fuck? That was just the best fucking chance that you could ask. I could ask for there. Okay. Chance gone, ish. All right, so nothing we could do there. I tried to tiptoe my way into the third goal, but just weren't able to do that. Okay, let's try and choke them up. Ugh, it's not working. Come on, come on. What the hell are you guys doing? I still want myself with bloody clean sheets, so you guys had better give me that clean sheets. Alright, so that's offside. Rise going off for Foden. Alright, so I think we should be in on goal here. Either, yeah, I think Fonseca got this. Definitely got this. Alright, so that is 3-0. I don't know why the hell it took that long to score the third goal, but I mean, they did pretty well. Even though most majority of the issue was the fact that we weren't actually passing like as best as we could. No, oh god, I hate it when I do something and the game just does something completely different. Really, really annoying. And can he still? No, that's high. That's fucking high. I still want to get. How the hell did I come off the ball there? Okay, that is good. 1 minute stoppage time, and that is the end. So we are winners of the La Liga for the sixth time. Fifth, I think it's the fifth time. I'm not sure, or fourth. Probably the fourth time that we're winning this trophy. We are actually the one and only team that is dominating all of football right now, even though we are not in the Champions League to prove that. But we're still possibly going to get a treble this season, even though it's not Champions League, which sucks. Really, really sucks, to be honest, but nothing we can really do about that. So we are going to be lifting the La Liga for the first time. Rather, we're going to be seeing us lift the La Liga trophy for the first time in a long ass time. You know, for the first time in this series in general. I don't think we've actually lifted that trophy yet. But once again, we're going to be lifting this magnificent trophy, and James is going to be the one that's going to be doing it. And there we go. Winners of the La Liga yet again. Two seasons in a row. And I'm really happy that this shit is happening right now. I wish Haaland was one in front there, but I mean Fonseca fits the bill. And he has probably scored a crazy amount of goals this season as well. So he's probably going to be getting his third Ballon d'Or next season, if I'm not wrong. Or his fourth. I think he should be his fourth. Now, the only match that is left for us to play, I really don't care about the Villarreal match. I just hope that we are able to win it, though. So, we draw against Celta Vigo. Don't know why the fuck we're doing that. But the last match against Villarreal, I really would like to win that match, to be honest. I really would love to win that match. We do 2-0. That is what I wanted. And now, we are going to be... Chill, let me just look at what else I need to do before I go into this match. Player charts. Tournament prize money, okay. 153,000. That is good. I've been playing pretty well. I'll think about it. Okay, I guess he didn't play. He probably hasn't played from the last match we had against that team rival Icano just now. So I guess I'm going to have to put him in for that guy. I don't know what his name is. Rise will also, you know, let's left footing start. And I think I am good. Mount hasn't exactly played. I doubt he's going to play. I mean, I'm selling him next season. So playable highlights is going to be the last month. I forgot to change the kits because their kit is closer to white than ours. Sorry, it's close to white. The only difference is the red that they have, the red stripe that they have. So. All right, I have no idea what stadium this is, but it's not looking like a very impressive stadium. It is the St. Mary Stadium where we're playing the fucking Europa League finals in Southampton's bloody stadium. What the fuck? I feel so downgraded, to be honest. But all right, let's see what we can do here. We're possibly going to get the win. The kits are not really aren't really helping me out that much here. But we have a counter attack, and I feel like Fonseca, obviously. That is crazy. I thought that. I honestly thought I pressed the X button to pass back to Fonseca there. I didn't know I pressed shoot. But whatever, it's still a goal for us. And we have another opportunity. Most likely going to be demolishing them this match. I have no idea where my players are, to be honest. But I think this is not very good. Because their backs are fully white, so it actually kind of confuses me. So don't know why the fuck I forgot. Let's see. No, I don't. So, I mean, the time I now go to that side, they decide to fucking play to the fucking left. God, penalties are so annoying. And we have a penalty, so we can get our revenge. And Fonseca. What? I took that to the fucking left. I took that to the bloody fucking left. This game is such bullshit. This game is such bullshit. What the hell? What the hell? Oh, this is so confusing. This is so bloody confusing. But you got this, right? No, you don't. That is not our player. Yeah, that's safely in Vandry's arms. And we have a solo run. Haaland is definitely not going to be missing from here. I mean, not from here. He's not going to be missing this chance, I hope. I really hope he doesn't miss it. Power shot, please. Thank you. Thank you so much for that. And that's a good goal. He's going to be getting a... possibly might get a hat-trick in this match, hopefully. If it calls for it. Okay, that was actually... We're able to keep that really well. Haaland on this. Let's see if he can get past the defender. Doesn't really have a lot of help here. I mean, I'm looking at Foden, who is possibly the best option, but I think I'm going to go all the way with Foden here. And yeah, that is... It's actually been long I've scored with him. So it feels really good to be able to do that. So 3-1 against Monaco in the finals. Are we going to have yet another opportunity? Yes, we do. And I have no idea who the hell I'm supposed to be passing to here. Oh my god. Okay, it could be anyone. How long get a hat-trick? You can't. Okay, what the fuck happened there? It's not happening as I would have wanted it to, but we still have the ball here. Let's try and regroup. And try and think of what the hell is going on. Okay, go and out of bounds there. Alright, let's see what Fonseca can do here. Should be able to get past the defender. Oh no! That would have been cool. That would have been cool if I was able to get around the keeper, but I probably tried to shoot earlier than I probably should have. No. Thank you, Helvig. Yeah, so that's the end of the match. We have won all the trophies that were available to us this season. We won the Super Cup, we won the Super Copa, we won the Copa del Rey, we won the La Liga, and we have won the Europa League. I really wish it was the Champions League, but we possibly might have a chance to do that again next season because we're still going to be able to play in the Super Cup. So that's going to be my goal for next season and for the last season. For the next 2 seasons, I want to win all the trophies that are available to us. So, it feels really good to be a winner, to be honest. And that is the Europa League trophy. I think this will be the first time that we're going to be lifting this, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, this is the first time that we're going to be lifting this. And it's not bad. It's not bad to lift it after lifting the Champions League. I mean, it's a trophy, so I mean, it's something. So
this is what they wanted. Now it's in their possession. The winners of the UEFA Europa League.
I honestly don't know why there's no crowd backing them, to be honest. It's so weird when they're lifting the trophy and then the fans are not even doing anything, guys. That is fucked up. But anyways, that's the end of the episode. Or the end of the matches in the episode, and we still have a couple things to do before we end it, like looking at the number of trophies we've won so far. If we don't count the preseason trophies and all that, we have won 5 + 3, that's 8 + 4, that's 12. We have won 12 trophies in general if you don't count preseason. But if I do, I'm going to sort everything out eventually. Our team is actually pretty close to 1,000 goals. I'm probably going to get that by next episode. By next season, we should be able to get up to 1,000 goals, I guess. Or let's say latest by the end of the series, we should be able to do that. Because when that's the Champions League win against Stuttgart there. So that is pretty good. I think Fonseca would also be getting the player of the season for Haaland. Was actually pretty close. He got third position there. Let's see. German is possibly also going to be on this list. He got 16 goals. Anyone else from our team? Those are the three main scorers in our team. So I mean, I'm not really surprised that no one else is in there. But let's look at the news real quick before we go into anything else. Camavinga impressed again. All right, that is good for him. Then ZM Cohetes, UEFA Europa League winner. That is good. And then player of the tournament. That's not my problem. It's my problem as well. Okay, what is this for? Okay, this is for the La Liga. He does get player of the tournament, and I'm pretty sure Badri gets this one as well. All right, so that is pretty good. That's pretty good. It's been a pretty good season. We pretty much did really well. Let's look at the La Liga standings real quick. 93 points. We got like 10 less than what we did last season. And I mean, it's still a really good victory. It's less than 10 points away from second position, but it's still something. And then last but not the least, we check the stats for the players. Foden, I feel bad for him, to be honest, but I mean, Fonseca doesn't really get as many goals as he got last season, but I think he gets as many goal contributions because he gets way more assists than he did last season. So that is 68 goal contributions in general. Haaland gets 28 goals and 11 assists. German in third position as always with 23 goals and 12. German was actually in second place last season. Not in goals, but in goal contributions, though. So 23 goals and 12 assists for him. And then Florian Wirtz gets 9 goals and 10 assists. Then Rize in 5th position with 9 goals and 4 assists. That is good for him. So this is the end of the episode. If you guys have enjoyed it, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Let me know what you guys think about this episode, what you guys think about the series in general. Is there anyone you would like to bring into the team for next episode? I mean, this entire thing is scheduled. I just want to know what you guys think and all, just, you know, to engage you guys and all that. So yeah, so once again, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next episode. Peace.